Pia leo mimi moyo wangu umejaa sana furaha kwa sababu ya mambo yale ambayo Mungu anafanya katika maisha yetu na kutafakari juu ya ukuu wake katika maisha yetu. And it is always good toward the end of the year just to take moments of reflection and think through what has happened in your life. And it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Amen. It will surprise you what the Lord has done. And you will sing that song meaningfully that indeed God has done so much for us. Today we want to look at, you know, when I read the bulletin in the morning, and the pastor's heart, when you start reading the pastor's heart, it's very scary for a pastor. Because it starts with the fact that every single Christmas day, the pastor says the same thing from the same person. So that is very scary, yeah? Every single Christmas day, the pastor says the same thing from the same person. So mimi na pastor mwenyangu atakuja hapa, na ataongelea kwenja, ataongelea kuza kwa Yesu, ataongelea kwenda kuandikishwa, and pastor, all of us will say the same thing. But today I was just thinking of someone. And this is Mary. I want us to think about Mary briefly. For those who will be in here on 25th, we will be doing a little bit of an apologetics of what Christmas really is. But today we just want to think of Mary. And particularly, tunataka kufikiria juu ya wimbo ama celebration ya Mary. You know, this lady called Mary. Is it something that clicks into your mind in kufikiria? Maria. Maria. Mama wa Yesu. I'm trying to push in so that you join me in my amusement as well. Like, this is Mary, a human being, giving back to God. You know, no wonder some people start praying to her. Because, are you trying to think of her? And so today we just want to think of her, and we are talking about Mary's song. We'll be reading a song that Mary mwenyewe aliimba celebrating the saving birthday, and we'll be looking at Mary's song. And when we're looking at Mary's song, we're looking at my identity, you know, Christ, my identity in Jesus Christ. And we'll be looking at Luke chapter 1, verse 46 to 56. But before that, tafadhali mniruhusu tu tuangalie juu kidogo about who this Mary really is. So let me push in something surprising here about Mary. Oh, that is the Mary, that is the picture of Mary we know. You know, I will not be surprised to find a different picture of Jesus Christ than the one I've always seen in the picture when I get to heaven. So I will not be surprised. But of course now maybe there are some people who walked with Mary and they thought that is her, pastor. Come I even here, even here. But that is the picture we know. But whatever the picture is, forget about the picture. Who is this man? Look at this surprising bit. Who was he? Was this Mary? Number one, that Mary has no historical records about her. Now that is a very painful part to start. When you are thinking about Mary, of course Mary will not be the same. Because you're thinking about Mary, no historical record of her has been mentioned. Unajaribu kutafuta katika historia, kujaribu kujua huyu Maria ni nani, ametoka wapi, kwao ni nani, watu wake ni akina nani. You know, we don't have that kind of record. And I'm saying, we don't have that kind of record for so many reasons. Let me just pinpoint some few reasons for us. You know, number one, I want to say the reason number one is her residence. You know, she lived in what we are calling hellness, or even the slums of Judea, where people were practicing farming. Mahali ambapo, you know, kulima, walikuwa wanafanya kulima. They are not likely from a wealthy or influential urban family with a means to keep records. So number one, why I think Mary's history is nowhere is because the kind of place where they live is the kind of place where some of us live, and you sometimes realize you don't even have a pen to write anything. You know, for those who, and I know majority of us, grew up in a time whereby, on a time such a unaenda kuomba kalamu. You know, it's very easy for us. You know, my kids, how I do it. Because wakienda kwa nyumba wanapata kalamu nyingi, ni hao wanachapua which one, which color to use. You see, ulikuwa unaomba kalamu. So, the kind of lifestyle that Mary lived, angeweza kupata historia kwa sababu, in the times or the places where they live, they did not have that kind of strength and wealth that will enable them to even have an idea of keeping records. After all, how many people have kept records of themselves? You know, you only keep record of yourself when you become a pastor of AIC Milimani. That's when you even start thinking of keeping records. Pastor Munyangu and I will now start thinking, because somebody will come and say, there was a pastor in AIC Milimani called Pastor Luke. What is Chigani alikuwa nayo? Then say, you know, sasa tunapatiana. Lakini huko kwetu yugi sile nilikuwa ni niko huko. Who will even want to live by this story? Who will even want to live that story? So they did not have records. Mary doesn't have any record. So number one is residence. Number two is her community. Her residence and her community. You know, Mary was a Jew and a member of a society which was subjugated under Roman rule. Nyakati hizo, Warumi ndio walikuwa wakiongoza the times. And one of the characteristics about the Roman leadership is that their records show that Romans generally did not care to record the lives of the people they were conquering. They did not care to record the lives of the people that they were conquering. Although, they took great care to document their own exploits. So even if you were small and they exploited you, they will record how they exploited you. It was a big point for them. But for the people whom they conquered, they did not find any interest to record. So, the reason why I'm trying to find the history of Mary and I don't find it, number one, is a place of stain in the slums of Judea, which they do not even get records or even have an interest or even anything that points them kuandika kitu juu yao. Ya pili, ninasema kwamba alikuwa ni ajibu ambayo walikuwa wanaongozwa na Warumi, na Warumi hawakuwa na nia ya kuandika historia juu ya wale watu ambao walikuwa wanaongoza. Lakini ninasema kwamba walikuwa na interest ya kuandika juu ya vile walikuwa wanaongoza watu, but not on individual people. But let me say this one, this is an unfortunate, the third thing, the third reason why I feel that Mary wasn't, her history is not known, is her social status. You know, Mary was a woman from a patriarchal society under the power of a patriarchal empire, where people were only noticed as men, and of course it is unfortunate I started like that. Individual women had no expectation of being remembered. But guess what? Unless, in America, unless they have status, wealth, or have performed heroic deeds in the service of men. So then, wanaume ni walikuwa wakiongoza. Na mama ama mwanamke ambaye hana cheo ama anafanya kitu kwa wanaume wengine ama ambapo hawakuwa na ama wakuwa na how to record things. Number two, nimesema kwamba alikuwa akiishi katika wanyakati ambao wanaume were taking lead and women who did not have status or big things could not be recorded. Na nimewaambia kwamba yeye pia alikuwa Myahudi ambao walikuwa kiongozwa na Warumi ambao they were not interested in taking notes about the people that they conquered. But number four, nafikiria pia, which is our age. In our age, scientific records estimate that women in many states achieve what we are calling the periods of menarche, or somewhere around 8-14 years. And, you know, at that age, you know, that is when people start recognizing that you are supposed to be taken care of. Now, as I will be telling you here, when you read at history and you look at the age of Mary, she was most probably around 13 years. Young girl. I'm getting to that. But you know her age. Who would dare want to record anything about a 13-year-old? Kama hajaenda Nobel Prize. Kama haja kariri shairi mbele ya president. Who will even dare know them? How many people know you? What do you want to write about yourself? Or what do people want to write about you? So I'm thinking that this is also part of what happened. Now, I'm saying, yeah, that Mary was a young girl, she was probably around 12, 13 years old when the angel Gabriel came to her. And, you know, this was a young girl who was recently engaged to a wonderful young man called Joseph. You know, Mary was an ordinary lady waiting to be married. Just the same scenario, things happened. She did not have all these things that, you know, are coming to her life all of a sudden, and things just start booming around her. So I'm saying, against this historical background, let me tell you, Mary's willingness to obey, yea, to obey, even the call of the angel, and the one angel says, you will give birth to a son, and you will name this son Jesus, you know, he's the savior of the world. That was a big obedience to what God was. Fikiria tu mambo haya. Ya kwanza, Maria ni mdogo. Kama umri, 12, 13. Ya pili, sio mdogo ambaye anaishi pahali Pastor Luke anaishi na wengine. Anaishi huko kitongoji duni ya Judea. Ambapo pengine hawana hata kalamu, pengine hawana hata taa ya kutumia kusoma. Pengine hawana mambo mengi ambao watu wengi hawana. Pengine they don't have so much. Namba ya tatu ni Myahudi ambaye anaongozwa na Warumi, who in themselves only take pride on their own self. Just try to think of this lady called Mary. Na anaishi katika familia ama katika community whereby wanaume ndio kusema, and she's a lady. So all of these things, I'm trying to look at Mary and compare Mary with angel coming to her, and it can, aingiani, you know, my the youth will say, hapo kidogo, you know, the angel will have decided to go to this one of these ladies whose names are recorded in the books, big books, in the county level, or even in the sub-county level. But the angel chose to go to Mary. And that is why she was so afraid. The Bible says she was so afraid. Vile aliona, you know, malaika alikuja kwake, she was so afraid. She could never have expected to hear that news
that she will be having a child, and that child will be the Messiah. That was the last thing that can ever, ever cross her mind.
Although she could not comprehend it, tunapata tukisoma Biblia anasema, let God's will be done. Amen. Wacha mapenzi yangu ifanyike. Kama unaonelea mimi Myahudi, ndio unaweza kutakuwa sawa. Kama unaonelea mimi ya Yanga, ndio unataka kutakuwa sawa. Kama unaona mimi msichana mdogo kati ya wanaume ndio unataka kutakuwa sawa. Choose. Let your will be done. But you know that is not the most important bit here, my friends. When she recognized that, Mary sang a song. Amen. Mary sang a song. Tell your friend, Mary sang a song. Now let us listen to this song. I wish I was musical enough. But now, because we are not musical, let us read the song. So let us turn to Luke chapter 1, verse 46, 46 and 56. Luke chapter 1, Luke chapter 1, I'll read verse 46 to 56. Na nataka tusome, tunaposoma wimbo huu wa Maria, tusome na hiyo historia in our mind. So that is going to give us the weight of the words and the choice of songs that Mary had. Mary akaanza kuimba, akasema, my soul glorifies the Lord. Amen? My soul glorifies the Lord. And my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servants. Now you realize why she's saying humble state? Because of the history. He's mindful of the humble state of his servants. From now on, all generations. That is interesting. From now on, not only from Judea, not only from my family, but from now on, the Bible says, what? I don't know what your Bible has. My Bible says, all. All. From now on, all generations will call me blessed. My name will get into history books. For the mighty one has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generations to generations. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud with their inmost thoughts. You know, maybe she was now alluding to the Roman, who are in their own pride, will not take care of them. But the Bible says he scattered them. What a song. He has brought down rulers from their thrones. But guess what he has done? Can you all read that, please? But he has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things. You know, I can understand that when she talks about hunger here. Remember I told you, in the hamlets of Judea, they will rarely sometimes even get something to eat. So when she talks about hunger, it is true. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors. Then, after the song, the Bible records, Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months, and then returned. Amen. You know, what about that song?
It is a song that all of us need to start finding some good lyrics about it, and then we ask our people here to design some good music for us. When she thought, alimfikiria mahali ambapo Mungu amemtoa, akatunga wimbo ya kumshukuru huyo Mungu na kutazama ukuu wake. You know, there is a song that we used to sing in the youth choir at home. My heart rejoices and rejoices to this God. Let me just pinpoint some few lessons from this song, and then we will be praying together. Number one, we say that the soul that Jesus Christ has revealed itself to, you know, the angel came and said, you are going to give birth to a son. This soul, this son here, is going to be called the Savior. Now, when the Savior comes into our lives, and this is how we need to start thinking about Christmas, that, you know, the birth of Christ provoked the heart of Mary to rejoice and to glorify Jesus. As the soul glorifies the Lord, and the spirit rejoices. When I think of Jesus Christ, my heart will glorify God, and my spirit will rejoice. Look at what Mary says. My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. Now, hii ndio tofauti kati ya Wakristo na wale ambao hawajui Kristo. Wakristo hata katika shida hawasahau jambo moja, kwamba Kristo yu ndani yao. Na Kristo akiwa ndani yetu anatupea furaha ile ambayo dunia haiwezi kutupea, and that gives us a reason to have the joy. So my prayer is that this Christmas, the birth of Jesus Christ will bring to our hearts this same joy, and will bring to our hearts to glorify God even more. Glorify God even more. The second thing I just want us to reflect about, just a matter of reflection. Just reflect about the mercy of God. Look at His mercy. The Bible says that His mercy extends to those who fear Him from generation to generation. His mercy extends to those who fear Him from generation to generation. Look at verse 50. His mercy extends to those who fear Him from generation to generation. The mercy of God is sufficient for us. His birth comes with that in mind, whereby His mercy comes to us, not only for Mary, but generation to generation of those who fear Him. Another bit is that He is mindful of us. Our God is mindful of us. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter whom you know. It doesn't matter what level of education you have. It matters that God is mindful of you. Amen. To me, that is so fulfilling, that God is mindful of me. You know what Mary says, He is mindful of me in my humble state. God is going to be mindful of us, we who appreciate His birth in our lives. And we need to start looking at Jesus as our Redeemer. His birth to us is coming to redeem us from whichever situation that we find ourselves in. Our God is mindful of us. The Bible says He has filled the hungry with the good things, but He has sent the rich empty. He has left His servant Israel, and He has remembered His promise. The Lord God will provide for us. When we think of Christmas, let us remember that number one, our hearts need to glorify God. Let us remember that God is mindful of our states, whichever state we are in, let us remember that God is merciful for us. Let us remember that God will fill our hungry bits of life. Spiritual hunger, physical hunger. When this Jesus is born in our hearts, just like he brought to Mary that fulfillment of the hunger, he's going to fulfill our hungry bits of our lives. But one thing that I want to note here is, what do we learn about the fact that Mary herself is adoring God for Jesus Christ? Mary recognizes that she is not God. She is not God. She is just an instrument being used of God to bring about his purposes for our lives. She is not God. That is why she is glorifying God. Her heart finds joy in God when she thinks of Jesus Christ. Not she thinking of giving birth to Jesus, but thinking of Jesus Christ being the Savior of the world. And I just want to push that for us. That then gives me an opportunity to start thinking that Mary herself recognizes that she's not God. And we can't even think of her as God. But she knows her lonely estate. She knows her humble state. And she glorifies God for that. Are you glorifying God for that thing? Friends, this is a reflection I want us to have. Let me just recap. As we think of this Mary who gave birth to Jesus Christ. Number one, we know that now this Mary is not one of these big name people in the society then. But God chose Mary from a humble place and lifted her. Then Mary says, I know you are the one who fulfills my hunger. Mary says, I glorify you because now all the generations will get to know me. Mary says, I know you are mindful of me. You remembered me when nobody else did. Mary says, I know that you know what you have done. You lifted me up. All generations will remember. I pray that this Christmas, that will be our portion. Amen. That will be your portion in Jesus' name. It will be your portion that God will be mindful of your estate. It will be a portion that God will make you to a level that generations will remember you. Even if there has never been something to remember, the Lord is going to impact that which to be remembered about you. It is going to be your portion in Jesus. It's going to be our portion as a church. It's going to be our portion that God is going to fill our hungry aspects, spiritual hunger, that God is going to fill it during this season. I pray that God is going to lift us this Christmas. And this is my prayer, even as we reflect today. What is the path of Christ bringing anew in your life? Is it just business as usual? For Mary, it wasn't business as usual. It wasn't just any other thing that needs to be done by anyone. She acknowledges the beauty of this. And somebody will say, Jay, what about birth of Christ? For Mary, it was not a usual birth. She recognizes that God is lifting. She recognizes that now generations will remember. She recognizes that God has lifted her from that humble state. She recognizes that God has changed the story of her life. Do you recognize that Jesus is going to do that exactly to your life? Let me ask Pastor Munyambo to come and just pray with us. And even as he prays with us, I want us to reflect on this, friends. What does the birth of Jesus really mean to your life? It really meant so much for Mary. What about you?